segment, I'd like to talk about blunders. What do you do when you make a really big mistake? What do you do when you make a blunder? Do you resign? Well, no. You really want to keep on fighting. And keep in mind that mistakes are part of chess. I've seen it over and over again when one side makes quite a number of mistakes and still manages to win the game, because the other side may make bigger mistakes later on down the track. Of course, blunders are serious setbacks, but still, there are things that you can do to minimize the damage that the blunder may cause to your position. So first of all, let me show you an example of a blunder. Let's say that white starts the game with the move d4. Black replies with d5, and now white plays c4, offering the pawn for free. Black looks at the position and happily takes that pawn. But black is now a pawn up. This, by the way, is Queen's Gambit accepted. White gives away that pawn if black takes it, but then the center pawn is for the moment removed away from the center, and white gains an extra move. So white's next move is e3. White tries to regain this pawn with his bishop. Black replies with b5, protecting the pawn. Now, when you see this structure, pawns on b5 and c4, this little pawn chain over there, this pawn chain can very effectively be attacked with a4. To break it up, black may think, okay, I'm going to defend my pawn with a6. But the problem there is, when white takes on b5, black cannot recapture because this rook over there on a8 is pinned. So ab5 would lose the rook on a8. For this reason, black may decide to play, instead of a6, the move c6. There are no pins now. So white takes, black takes, and only now black realizes that this was a bit of a blunder. Why? Because this diagonal leading towards the rook on a8 is now wide open and it cannot be adequately protected. To make use of this diagonal, white's next move is queen to f3, attacking the rook. Big blunder, black is in trouble. What to do? Well, the first thing to do is take a big breath. Don't transmit to your opponent that you just made a mistake. So don't go, ah. Well, if you keep a bit of a poker face, that will be best, because that way your opponent might have up a doubt or two about the blunder that you have just made. Also, if you don't give away any signs about the mistake that you just made, very often people will overlook it, and instead of playing, say, queen f3, they might just continue the development with knight f3 or play bishop e2 or something else, and then you get a chance to correct that mistake. Many blunders go unnoticed. Next, and this really is very, very important, when something like this happens, try to minimize the damage. What does it mean? Well, in this particular case, the rook is under attack. Okay, it can't be adequately protected, but you don't really need to lose the whole rook. You can play, for example, a move bishop b7. Queen will take the bishop, but after knight to d7, the queen is protecting the rook. So instead of losing the whole rook, you're going to lose only your bishop. Plus few pawns, because this pawn on b5 is now not protected and white can happily punch it. So there is an even better move here, and that better move would be to play knight to c6. Queen takes, check, forking the king and the rook, but black now plays bishop to d7. So the queen is protecting the rook, and the bishop is attacking the queen, protecting this pawn on b5, so it can't be taken. And okay, you lost the piece, but you didn't lose the rook. You didn't lose any of those pawns over there, and the game goes on. You still have a chance. Once you have a position like this, try to keep the position complex. Keep it complicated so that your opponent cannot easily realize the advantage. swap of pawns if need be, because if you think about it, if you swap off all the pawns and all the pieces, well, you will be one piece down, but that is not going to be enough to win the game. So it's okay to swap off pawns, but don't swap off the pieces. Keep your pieces alive so that you can do the battle. And you will be surprised in how many cases you will be able to turn the situation around and from a losing position after making a blunder, still be able to outplay your opponent. And this is how you play when you make a blunder.